In this video, I will summarize the information I got from ForgeRock Identity Management Deep Dive Training. The first session is more about describing identity management deployment and the UIs. So in this screen, you could see that when you embark on IDM and when to deploy, you have got several options. You have got identity card as type of deployment. You have got ForgeOps, it means ForgeRock DevOps, which provide a number of resources to help you get started in the car. This is resource that demonstrate how to deploy the ForgeRock identity platform on Kubernetes. And you have got AM and IDM can be deployed in parallel, and IDM can be installed by itself standalone. In this sharing, we will focus more on the IDM standalone since that's what the training session focused on. So the first one, for identity card, ForgeRock is the host. They manage it, and customer don't have to worry about installing it. We don't have to worry about upgrades and all of those sorts of things and patching and all of that. That's all managed by ForgeRock themselves. Second one, ForgeOps. If you choose to do a cloud-based deployment using ForgeRock, the customer or you as the implemental deployer or the consultant are responsible to host them on pretty much on their chosen cloud platform, whether it be Azure, Amazon, Google, or Red Hat, whatever it is support. And AM and IDM in parallel. If they are choosing to do an AM and IDM in parallel kind of deployment, that means it will have to be a direct LDAP directory server, and it would have be a ForgeRock one because AM required that a shared identity store, and then IDM and AM can be tightly integrated, sharing the same repository. That is what it means by them being in parallel. So the customer will provide the host information and be responsible for hosting the environment. And similarly for the standalone, IDM standalone. So in an architectural model, identity card is basically a SaaS model, software as a service. ForgeOps technology based on doing a Kubernetes style deployment. So using ForgeOps is set of tools that ForgeRock provide that allow you to quickly create your own configuration and deploy your own configuration that you can deploy to a Kubernetes on a cloud host or public cloud. If you choose AM and IDM in parallel, then you are deploying them on whatever the operating system purchased or owned by the customer. And same with the IDM standalone. In IDM repository perspective, ForgeRock use the directory service. Whether you see DS in the sharing, we are talking about the ForgeRock directory service or the LDAP technology that is maintained by ForgeRock. If you are using ForgeOps, the default is using DS as the IDM repository. As you will learn a standalone IDM, you can actually use a relational database as an IDM repository. And you can do the same in ForgeOps, but it might take a little bit extra work to configure it. If you are choosing AM and IDM in parallel, it depends on the installation. If you choose to share identity repository with AM, so the AM and IDM in your repository as a source of a credential for authentication purposes and authorization purposes, then you actually do need to use a ForgeRock directory service. But if you separate the identity repository instead of sharing between AM and IDM, then you have got your choice. You can choose AM or stay with the DS. And identity management can be a relational database. It is up to your design. Same with standalone IDM. Can be directory service, or it could be a support JDBC environment database in a relational level. Okay, so in a workflow engine available, workflow is not available in Identity Card at the moment, and it is possible with the ForgeRock technology, but you need to do some extra work with JDBC, which is not part of the tool set the ForgeRock provides for cloud Kubernetes-based cloud deployment. It is possible to have workflow with AM and IDM in parallel in the and also in the standalone type of deployment. In the authentication part or SSO, the authentication, in identity card we do single sign on with AM because an identity management manager and the ForgeRock directory server all tightly integrate in identity card. They are all used together in a very typical integrated way. If you are using ForgeOps as your deployment mechanism, basically SSO is also done with AM because due to deploying pretty much all three technology, but you have got control over the customization. But if you are using identity card, you don't have control over customization because it is managed by ForgeRock, and ForgeRock has to approve any customization and make sure it is secure enough to implement. So if you want to have more control, you may want to consider ForgeOps type deployment or for a cloud-based Kubernetes kind of deployment. By the way, Identity Cloud is based on a Kubernetes type deployment platform. It originally started using ForgeOps technologies, but it has actually diverted a bit in terms of the code base now, just because the needs are different and everyone has a dependency of having to wait for ForgeOps to get update to support their requirement as time progresses. So that's why we have Identity Cloud and ForgeOps, two type of deployment options for now. Single sign-on within AM and IDM in parallel. Basically, AM does the single sign-on, but you do have the option of using IDM for doing single sign-on. You have got a choice of AM and when they are in parallel. In the case of a standalone IDM, there's no AM involved in IDM supplies the authentication capabilities. It is not as rich as what AM can do, but it is enough to do some basic. So that's all for this explanation for this table about IDM deployment options.